Here's my answer. The first thing I did was to fill in the diagonals. These should all be zero unless there's a negative cycle. Thankfully, there's only one negative path found so far, and I can easily check that it doesn't create a negative cycle. When we use 4 as an intermediate vertex, I could go from 3 to 4. That would cost negative 3, but going back from 4 to 3 would cost 6, and so then the overall cost would be 3, which is greater than 0. 0 is better. Next, I filled in the values where 4 was either a source or a destination, since vertex 4 can't help as an intermediate vertex in those situations. Now for the remaining entries. The choices for going from 1 to 3 are either to use the old path, which costs 4, or to go from 1 to 4, and then from 4 to 3. That costs 7, so the old path is better. How about going 2 to 1? Well, there is no old path, but there is a path through 4. I could go from 2 to 4, that would cost 1, and then from 4 to 1, which would cost 2 more, for a total of 3. That's good. Going from 2 to 3 was impossible before, but using vertex 4, I can go 2 to 4 for a cost of 1, and then 4 to 2 for a cost of 6 more, for a total of 7. 3 to 1 is another path that's impossible without going through 4. But if I do go through 4, then going 3 to 4 costs negative 3, and going 4 to 1 costs 2, for a total of negative 1. Lastly, we have that going from 3 to 2 used to cost 2, but we can improve on that by going to 4 first, which costs negative 3, and then going from 4 to 2, which costs 1, for a total of negative 2. And that completes the answer.